welcome to Gord Field here in Detroit Rock City, home of the Motor City Maniacs. I see the Maniac fans are trying to get the fire wave going, but so far just a small number of fires and mostly just on the upper deck.
Yeah, they've really stepped up security, Ben. In the men's room earlier, I only witnessed 3 random assaults and 2 of them were on me. Not bad for gang day.
Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Crux and Skull Jugulars battle the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Like your cocktail cold, your soup hot, and your steak still mooing, then you're gonna love seeing mutants knocked cold, their brains turned into hot lava soup, and their bodies strewn about the field, lying still and barely moving. MFL Game Day is on the air.
Ah, you just made me hungry, Grim. I'm gonna go get some of them extra crispy mutant finger strips.
Hey, get me a full slab of broken mutant ribs while you're there.
And it's 1st and 10. Second down in a very lot. A great throw and a great catch, but sadly to the wrong team. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a winner ever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And it's 1st and 10. Second down in a lot.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's lost his mind!
Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after the...
That's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this ref.
Yeah, that penalty came him by the nuts.
Second down and 2. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's 1st and 10. Will give them a 1st down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
1st down and 9. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just perfect pass and a score. Looks like someone uploaded some new dance moves. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. first and 10. And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. Up second and tired of the quarterback's tight spirals, and then on sportsmanlike play of the day brought to you by the good folks at Speedy's Drive-Thru Funeral Parlor Service, located just off the Beltway exit 5. And it's first and 10. That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and 10. And he breaks away. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
And it's first and 10.
He hit that line the way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and 10. Pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. Give him 10 yards. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Well, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the changes, Gordon, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Third down and 10. Mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Second down and 7. And the quarterback calls it, and like breaks his balls. He is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10.
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck.
Boom! And it's first and 10. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. First and 10. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
And it's first and 10. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. Huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Mockman, that was a pass play. Rolling plays him in bowling.
Third and 2. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And he just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? He could go all the way. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. Oh, and he loses the ball along with his life.
When did we become so numb to all this?
I honestly can't remember.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10. Oh. knucklehead. And it's first and ten. And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and three. Oh, with the brutal hit. Third down and five. You idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. The offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. You need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. First and two. Mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and ten. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. The unstoppable force meets the explodable object. Nice pickup for 6 yards. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Ben?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
Third and four. Shitty pass to absolutely no one. And the punter has one job to do, and that's punt the ball. They let the punt drop, and it will be down by the defense. And it's first and ten. Second down and long. If he had getting killed by a chainsaw before he completed his bucket list on his bucket list. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message.
The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. And it's first and 10. Target, a pickup of 6 yards on the play. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And that'll be second down and 4. He is fighting for every yard. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
The offense has no running backs left, so they will lose all running plays in their playbook. And it's first and 10. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Team hates it.
And it's first and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Hey, Grim, what if interceptions counted as...
He broke free and has open field in front of him.
Hey, man, nobody can cut you an eyeball. I take all you new cap.
And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely at a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and 10. The defender says, I don't think so. Third down and 10. Defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in the...
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Does the QB know which team? Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. In a hurry. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. Now this one's gonna be tough. I hope he has a good enough leg for this one.
I saw him trying one on before the game. He looked okay, I think. Not my type, though.
Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they can start cheating and killing. That's what I do.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. 10-yard pickup there. Normally a first down, but here, he's just making up ground.
Yeah, like the way the commish makes up news.
Third down and long. Point with multiple interceptions. The QB and the NFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and ten. First and ten. And it's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more risk. Ooh, that hit's going to shave a few days off his life. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, I mean, he was a great ball player. You know, that's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. You just throw it to the guy in the same color jersey as you. You got it? Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the NFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
First and ten. Second down in a mile. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. And it's first and ten. And the quarterback throws another pick. He's with a punishing hit. And it's first and ten.
Ah, another interception. Please, you give this guy a bigger.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten. Oh, nice hit. Another turnover. Oh, and he just left an outline. Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the NFL. And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some pow? And how about a little dirt sandwich? Kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing when he was in school.
Yeah.
Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. Offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And it's first and ten.
sure now he catches it.
I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
Oh, man, what a threat. And like Rex and Bowles, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
First and 10. Does the QB know what? Oh, there goes the ball. It's a fumble.
Is it still a fumble if his hands are attached to the ball?
And it's first and 10. Look at that little mutant run!
I don't think you can say that, Grim!
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. First and 10. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Second down and 10. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give them a pat on the head and tell them they don't suck.
Third down and 10.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not young.
And it's first and 10. Toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And that is called for a first down. That's the end of the third quarter. And look, folks, I'll be honest, I don't see a chance in hell in here. First down and one. And the defense jumps on sides. This guy can talk before he died. What do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck?
The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
Nah, this new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
First down and one. And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, Grin. Like a haiku.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
And the quarterback throws another... Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay!
And it's first and ten. Point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more reception.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time.
I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
The defense lost another linebacker on that play, and only two remain on their roster. Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. The QB looks angry at his offensive line, and I can't blame him. Third down and forever. Crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potatoes. The Motor City Maniacs get their butts whipped and lose by forfeit. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Today's game was brought to you by Comcrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.